Hi everyone, feel very welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Life After on your PC. From now you can display it on screen. It takes almost no time to effortlessly download and install Life After so that we can enjoy playing your game on our Windows PC with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's go buddies. Before anything else folks, to get started we have to open our favorite browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL that I'm highlighting in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's a clickable link in the video description and the first main comment. We ended up right here on our website of Usitility, exactly where we get an in-depth overview on how you can obtain Life After on personal computer. We search down a bit and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we will run to play Life After on our PC. As you can discover from here, we have a number of pros of running the emulator. So we will proceed to download the Life After by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. The step is clicking on it. Of course, the download action starts and ends immediately. Here it is, this is the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to launch the installer, so we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the device. We said yes. I minimize the browser to view the installer better. The installation software is straightforward. It includes two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path actually does. We just click it, and therefore we observe that we get here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be set up. If we need to change for better this directory, we have to click on that browse button, and we opt for another directory and install the emulator wherever we like. I prefer to leave it by default. I click on back. Therefore I simply click on install. Fantastic! The installation starts and it will move forward together with the download of these MB which are shown on this screen. When you save it on your machine, it could be more or less MB. The data transfer rate can be faster or slower, based on your type of access to the web and depending on the performance of the emulator web servers. At the moment they're progressing very fast. The download has been successful, and at this point it proceeds with the setup step. The installation needs more or less time based on the strength of your computer. The more powerful it's actually, the shorter the installation time and or vice versa. If we add together the download and software setup phase, it may take quite a while, so show patience. It has by now ended on my side. At present, the emulator has been launched instantly. As you can discover, down here, there is a progress bar that will fill up so when it actually reaches the ending, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. Indeed the emulator has already been launched, here it is for the first time. Before we keep going, as you can discover, it made two software icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is definitely the one we're considering. Whenever we need to operate Life After on our desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on this icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi-Instance app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything like that, basically, it is an app icon that we might most likely never start using. Shall we do the next step, which is a requirement, and that's to enter the Google Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is launched. There we need to sign in. So now when we are here, we are required to accomplish the next phase that is compulsory. So that we click on Sign In. Presently it says Checking Info. It may from time to time get blocked in Checking Info, and this doesn't proceed. In this case, you can try to log in after a couple of hours and it'll most certainly be corrected. At this time we will type in our login name and password. The email has to be a Gmail email and its matching password. As an example you may use the same email you are using right now in your own YouTube account. Then I will enter my information and I will go back as soon as I have completed it. Voila, data inserted. This is Google welcoming us and providing us the terms of service. We would approve all of them by simply clicking on I agree. Following that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can let it checked and it'll make a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you can make use of that feature if you desire. We simply click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched by default and instantly. To set up the app game, we have to get to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking the icon marked green colored. At present that we are on the desktop of the emulator, we observe that we now have here the install app button. We simply click on this button. Listed here we get the video game. Why don't we press there on the install option that I'm just displaying now in green color. That click will begin the setup. At this moment it should download and install the Android game, it will take a little while or perhaps it could be very fast. It again all relies upon on our connection to the internet. This has by then finished installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by hitting that button that I'm presenting in green, to be able to use LifeAfter for the first time. Now let's mouse click on the My Games option proceeding. You are by now on the emulator desktop, and consequently we are about to simply click on this fresh LifeAfter app icon which has been provided. Your game is launched for the first time. Currently there we have it, I'm able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to comment on the volume of the emulator. It's here. We have the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume, this way we are not going to count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the max, we can switch on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This one is the first one, we mouse click on this particular icon that I am identifying in green color. Thus the screen is maximized, getting one border at the top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. Granted that we really want to appreciate the game in full screen, we click this application icon. And thus we would by now be enjoying the video game in full screen mode. To escape the 100% screen setting, hit the F11 key. And we'd by now be in regular computer screen mode. At present, I am starting to reveal you the keyboard mapping that is actually extremely useful. This strategy we will probably be able to use the game application much more easily. The very first task is to press this keyboard icon. It's now time to make the necessary adjustments. I am about to keep the normal configuration, however if you really want to change it, you may very well achieve it without any problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is totally in our language. From time to time it happens that the emulator is launched in the erroneous language, as an example, in Japanese. And as a consequence to set it in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. And thus here within other configurations, we simply click on the language drop-down. We can also determine the language we prefer, Italian, Mandarin, etc. Once the language is determined, we should save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the game application, the next time we run it, would of course be in the selected language. So now, there is another aspect that we must take into account, and it is that we will receive a message from Google telling that a brand new equipment has been connected to our Google account. It will definitely ask us if we are the people who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we shouldn't worry, considering the fact that emulator is emulating an Android smartphone or tablet. So you can discover which electronic device is being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Let's go here to the model option. And here we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for this tutorial. I believe you liked it, particularly that everyone found it handy. If that's so, give it a good thumb up, subscribe, and any remarks, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment box below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams on occasion, you get it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Just click any of those training videos which are usually showing up on the computer screen and see you in the future video tutorials. Bye.